Welcome to Naresai Technologies. This is Ramchandar. In this video, I'm going to describing about a very good program on top of programming on try and multiple catch block. Try and multiple catch block. See, let me take notepad. Here I'm taking one notepad like class test. In the test class, I'm taking one method, public static void main string array s. Now here I'm taking one try block s. In the try block, I'm taking like what, your system dot out dot println try block. Okay, now let me copy this code. Let me write catch block. Now whenever we writing the catch block, we need to think something here. What is that something? Now observe here. When catch block is going to execute, whenever any exception is raises in the try block, then only catch block executed. How do you know about whether the particular exception is raises in the try block? Sometimes we know that, sometimes we don't know that. For example, observe int a equal to 10 by 0. In that particular time, I know that exception object is arithmetic exception. That exception object is what here? Arithmetic exception. In that particular time, whenever exception is raised in the try block, JVM automatically will hold that object and place it and hand over to whom? Catch block parameter. Now here I'm writing like what here? Arithmetic exception E. So that arithmetic exception object will come and place into variable E. For example, if I don't know that exception name, then what can we do? In this particular scenario, we must and should be use one concept, upcasting. Already around 2 videos I given on top of the upcasting and downcasting concept. If you have any doubt, will you please go through that videos. Upcasting means placing subclass memory into superclass. So here in entire exception handling concept, exception is the superclass for all the checked and unchecked exceptions. Nothing but whatever the discussion we had in previous videos, exception class is the superclass for runtime exception as well as what here? Compile time exceptions. So here arithmetic exception is comes under what here? Runtime. So runtime is the subclass of what here? Exception. Runtime exception classes are the subclasses of exception class. So what we need to do? These runtime exception classes of memory, we can place it into variable reference variable like what here? Super class like exception. So if you know exact exception message, then we can write what here? Arithmetic exception. Otherwise we need to write what here? Exception. Let me show the proof. This is what here? Catch block AE. Now Java C test dot Java. Now there is one println statement mistake. Println, good. Now clear the screen. Now observe guys, Java C test dot Java and Java test. Then what happened? Try block executed, catch block executed. In the try block, some exception is raises. That I know that exception name is arithmetic exception. The same parameter type I taken in the catch block. If I don't know, definitely we should go for what? Definitely we should go for what here? Exception. Like that is the super class. In that particular time, there is no problem. That exception object will come and place into variable AE. So if you want to know that, if you want to know that exception name, if you want to know that exception, whether it is arithmetic exception or not, print stack trace, one method I'm using. We'll see what is the print stack trace and very in detail in the next video. So what is that exception object? Arithmetic. Arithmetic exception object will place it into variable reference variable type E. What is that reference variable type here? Exception. Now, here arithmetic exception, I know that. Now what happened here? String, not string here. Let me use system dot out dot println RAM dot char at of 4. So in this particular time, what happen? Exception is rises, and that nothing but internally one object is created by the JVM and handover to what here catch block. So that is not matched with the what here arithmetic exception. Already I told you in the last video. In the last video, what is that? Whenever exception is rises, JVM will check the condition, selecting the class, creating an object, adding message, and finally handover to catch block. So when the catch block is going to executed, once the catch block is matched with that exception object, if not matched, control goes to, if not matched, control goes to where here? Console. So here, exception in thread main java.lang.stringindex out of bound exception. But I want to hold it. But I want to hold that one. How? With the help of one more catch block. So let me copy and paste here. Here the catch block name. Here the exception type is what here? String index. String index. String index. Out of bounds exception. Now here I'm writing one shortcut format. String index out of bound exception. Now observe here. Java C test.java and Java test. Which one is executing? String index out of bound exception. Whenever exception is rises in the try block, the control goes to the nearest catch block. If the nearest catch block is matched, then it will executing. Otherwise, the control goes to where here? Next catch block. If the next catch block is matched, that will executing. Otherwise, next. If there is no other catch block, control goes to console. Now, one more thing. What here? Int array A equal to new int of minus 1. New int of minus 1. Then exception is rises. Why? Array size must and should be starts with the 0. That is not matched with arithmetic exception. Not matched with string index out of bound exception. Then automatically it will print it on the where here? Console. But I don't want to print that. I hand over to the console. I want to handle. Then what I need to do? Then I need to write here one statement, that is here I need to take one negative array size exception. Now here I am taking like negative array size exception. Now one more exception is rises. What is that one more exception? System dot out dot control Z. System dot out dot println. System dot out dot println new int array 1, 2, 3 dot 4 or dot 3 or dot 2 of 2 Java C test dot Java Java test. So this is one array which doesn't having any name, unreferenced array this is. Or some people we can call it as what here, anonymous array, a array which doesn't having any name. So from this array, I'm printing the second value. Now let me print, what is that? Third value. Third value means what here? Third index value. So there is no third index value. So definitely exception is raises. It is not matched and it is also not matched. Then control goes to where here? This catch block, it is also not matched. Then after the control goes to where here? Console. I don't want to give the chance to print the exception details on the console. I want to handle. I want to provide some user-friendly messages. Then I can go for this. Now, in this particular time, I don't know the exception name. The exception name is basically array index out of bound exception. Assume I don't know. But I want to handle. I want to hold that one. So, then we can go for the super class like what here? Exception. Now, Java C test.java and Java test catch block executing negative array size exception. So, copy and paste now. So, this is what here? Exception. Yes. Now, Java C test.java and Java test. So, catch block exception is rises. Exception block will be executed. Catch block with exception parameters. Now, so this is what exactly try with the multiple catch block. Now here one of the very important question, that is, see guys, Java C test.java, there are three errors especially under the arithmetic exception, string index out of bound exception, as well as negative array size exception. So what is the mean here? Will you please read out the message? Exception message has already been caught. So what is the meaning here? Already I discussed like for all the for all runtime exception, for all compile time exception. What is the super class here? Exception class. So whatever the exception is raised in the try block, always compatible with what here? This catch with the exception block. If it is arithmetic exception, I can hold with the help of exception parameter. If it is a string index out of bound exception, I can hold with the help of exception parameter. If it is a negative array size exception, I can hold with the help of exception parameter. If it is a array index out of bound exception, in this time also we can hold with the help of exception parameter. So every exception object is going to hold by this catch block. Then when these three are going to execute, lifelong these three catch blocks are not going to execute. If the statements are not going to execute in entire lifetime of an application, should we write unnecessarily? That's why here one we need to give the one conclusion. If you are, whenever you attempt to write multiple catch block, if you are trying to write catch block with exception, that is always end of the all the catch block. In this particular scenario is also what here? Error. Now in this time it will giving two error. There may be a chance of execution arithmetic exception, but whenever string index exception is raises, negative array exception is raises, everything is held by the exception. Now observe here, Java C testers have two exception. So the final conclusion is, whenever you trying to write catch with exception, those must and should be right end of the all the catch blocks. So now successfully compiled, now successfully executed. This is the program related to try with multiple catch blocks. I hope you enjoy this video. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh IT channel. Thank you.